Easy for that small business owner. There's a lot of struggle. There's times where you need to meet the payroll, and hey, maybe you won't get paid yourself, you know, when you're first starting out. But that's the sacrifice that you make when you start a small business. And so in your book, there's a lot of focus on work ethics and business tips. And what I would like to know from you, well, first of all, we all know that behind all successful men are very strong women. And I believe your wife, Corey, probably played an important part in the growth of that company, right? Am I right?
How right you are. No, really, and I've given her credit. And I've said, you know, without her, I don't think I ever could have accomplished the things that I have personally. Just her being there, especially when you're doubting yourself and doubting what you can do and you just can't see it. And just her pushing and saying, hey, we can do this. We can do this together. And she comes from a business family, so she was very instrumental, she and her family, about knowing business and knowing, you know, we can overcome. And we didn't. We didn't come from that business. We just run our business. But she had come from retail. And so, you know, she got a great head on her shoulders. She's way smarter than me. And so she's a reader and all that. So that's why I married young. Yeah, that's why we married young, because she and I went to college together. So without her, I probably could have made it through college. So she's been instrumental. And then also just making sure that the family's taken care of. And, you know, with our little ones, when they were little, we used to have duck calls everywhere all over our house too, just like when we were kids, because we ran the internet business out of our living room. And so we would answer the phone at all hours of the night and take orders and, you know, send emails back. And in a lot of ways, it was like I grew up, you know, getting dust manned off the ground. We did that through the internet, through social media. And by the way, the reason we did that is because my dad totally was not a believer in computers and said nobody would ever order any products off the computer. And he still doesn't have one, so he stuck with it. But I said, Dad, I really think these computers and this internet is going to be a big deal one day.
Your mom and dad are such a joy and a blessing to watch. And I got to tell you, first of all, you boys all married some beautiful women. I mean, they are gorgeous. They really are. So smart and beautiful. That's a great combination. But one of the things I have to tell you, as a Christian myself, a very conservative person, I appreciate your show so much. And I find it amazing, but I shouldn't, I guess, that you have the numbers of viewers that you do. And I think about how unashamedly you end each and every program with a prayer. You all gather around the table, you bow your heads and you pray and you thank God for all of your blessings. And you know, that has not discouraged people from tuning in to watch your show. In fact, it's quite the opposite. You've got followers all over who may not even believe the same as you do, who may not even have a faith, but they love that show. And people still are drawn to the wholesomeness out there, the goodness. We want to be reminded that there are good people and that this world isn't as crazy as it appears to be sometimes. And I have to applaud you for your bravery and for doing that and being so vocal in your faith.
Well, thank you. I mean, we've done that from the start of our company. And Dad, I remember back in 1980, you know, he got up in New Orleans and I was at a hunting show and he said, I'm going to give you a little duck call and then I'm going to give you a little preaching too. And a lot of folks said, Bill, you can't mix the two. You know, you're going to have to leave that stuff out if you're going to grow your business. And he didn't, and the Lord's blessed us over and over and over with that. And we've never really shied away or backed down. And I think our show is, it's generally funny. And so you got an odd combination. It does have Christian themes about it, but it doesn't sacrifice the funniness of it. And, you know, I mean, sometimes things that are made from a Christian basis aren't quite as good as what, you know, comes out of Hollywood. And this particular show, I think, can stand up against any show as far as comedy and where it comes from. It also has, you know, a Christian faith about it. We pray at the end, and, you know, the relationships are good. You're not going through cussing and fighting and all that, even though we disagree, just like every family does. But, you know, at the end of the day, we want to show you come back together, you set that table, and that's pretty much where you end it, you know, and you let it go, and then the next day is a new day, and you get after it. And I think that's a great message for us as Americans and us as families, you know, to learn how to get through problems and how do you get through that, because it hasn't always been easy for us, but we've stuck together, and today we're going to make it through.
And that's why the book is really, I find, quite interesting, and it really is good to read once you've come to know your family, Duck Commander family. I got to tell you, you talk about comedy. Where would you be comedy-wise without Uncle Si? Listen here, wow. You know, I just love that guy.
He is such a nutcase, yeah. You know, we've always known him as the crazy uncle, and didn't really know how that was going to translate. And honestly, when we started the show, he wasn't even on the list of people. And I told the production company, I said, you really need to look at my uncle, because he's quite the character. Of course, when they saw him and saw him on screen, they were like, holy cow, Willie, where did you get this guy? But I told you, he was funny. And watching him grow and how he does it, and, you know, and everybody asked me, is he really like that? And I'm like, could you fake that for that long? You know, I mean, the guy's, he's an odd cat, but so funny and really a good, pure guy, too. And watching him with all the fame now and success, it's extraordinary because he still, I mean, every time he gets a check from this, he just laughs and says, I cannot believe that these people have lost their minds to pay me to do what I do, and which is cool. I mean, watching him be so humble, you know, even though he's probably one of the most talked about people in America.
I love it. My favorite episode was when your brother lost his wedding ring and Si said, oh, I have a metal detector, and he said, I'll be right back. And then, of course, he never came back. He decided to look for metal in his own yard, and just a crazy character. I love him. But would you tell us all about the history of how the show began, and how in the world did this happen?
Yeah, how'd they find us? Well, we had a show. We were doing outdoor TV. We've been doing outdoor stuff for years. We made VHS tapes back in the 80s of our hunts, and just kind of a raw, real show about us hunting, and had a lot of tips and techniques, and but also kind of in your face, and we had the beards, and everybody was kind of gnarly, and then that eventually moved into TV, where we had a show on the Outdoor Channel, and it was kind of reality, kind of hunting, and kind of a new show of its time a few years ago, and it was very successful, and people loved it. It was just a really small network, and there was a guy, just a producer, he had been from Louisiana, he owned a production company out in L.A., and he sent me just an email to the general inbox, just the Duck Commander, and said, I think you guys got a big show, you know, give me a call, and called him up, and made a couple of pilots and showed them around. A lot of people wanted the show when they saw the pilots, and A&E kind of came out of nowhere and said, we'll take a chance on it, and made a couple of pilots. They liked it, and, you know, we shifted it into the show it is, you know, trying to find that perspective to find, how are you going to make this show? And it ended up being out of my perspective, because I was like the normal guy trying to run a business and trying to get my family to do these things. So it kind of came from my eyes, and then certainly they saw the comedy, because we didn't know. I mean, I don't think they realized that it was going to be that funny, and we were thinking kind of gritty at the time, like a Swamp People, you know, that was kind of what was in vogue at the time, and then it morphed into this real pro-family, positive comedy of how we run our business, and there you go, you know. As the numbers turned out, it was some huge ratings, and it grew and grew every week. It was growing, and we knew people were calling and telling people, hey, you got to check this show out, and it was fun watching it during that time.
You know what, and I have to say, too, that it's just been so much fun to watch, and as a parent who is trying to instill those same values in her child, to see someone out there enforcing that on a show that's become as popular as yours has, I mean, it's just it's a blessing for many of us. One more story, if you don't mind, and that is about your dad, because Phil has a background in football that many people may not know about, and I only learned about all of the details after reading the book, Duck Commander Family. If you could just quickly give us a little background on your father and what he decided, it always cracks me up on what he just found, how he finally decided he didn't win football, but he'd rather be where he is right now.
Well, yeah. Yeah, he was a big football star out of northwest Louisiana, the Shreveport area. Came out, got signed to Louisiana Tech. He was a starter quarterback, had a bright future. And another guy came along right behind him named Terry Bradshaw, of course, who we all know who he is. And but dad was a starter. He was a backup, and that's probably the way it was going to be. But the problem with Phil was there was a big problem with football. It happened at the same time as duck season. So he never could quite get over that. So his senior year, he literally just walked away and said, I'm going to get my degree, and I'm going to leave football behind. And, you know, he never looked back. And he could have went and played pro, obviously, and but he didn't. And he said, I'm going to chase the Ducks, you know. And he always says, Bradshaw went after the Bucks, and I went after the Ducks. And both of them ended up okay. And we worked it all the way around, or we ended up making a few bucks off those Duck calls anyway.
Well, listen, I'm from Pittsburgh. I still live there, and Terry Bradshaw was one of my favorites, all-time favorites, in fact, having been in Pittsburgh and a huge Steeler fan, of course. You know, it's funny because your dad also said that dating interfered with duck season, so he initially broke up with your mom right before duck season, so he didn't have to be bothered with anything else.
Mom learned at a young age, you know, how he was going to be, so they've been together ever since, and we're all thankful for that, and he's written the book. Too, it'll be out the pre-selling now, but it's doing really well. But it should be out, I think, Father's Day, and it's called Happy, Happy, Happy. So it tells his story and kind of where he came from. So it's real neat to see that. And my wife actually just read it on the plane the other day, and she said it's awesome. So I look forward to reading it. I hadn't read it yet.
Oh, I can't. I'm looking forward to that. I really am. Well, listen, I want the audience to know they can get a copy of Duck Commander Family. I know it's on Amazon.com, but also I think it's at DuckCommander.com, right?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, we sell them too. And they're all over. I mean, it's done real well. It's been on the best-selling list several weeks, and we're proud of it. And, you know, Phil's got his coming out, and Cy has one too coming. So, Psychology 101. So, be looking for it too. You'll enjoy that. Some of Cy's inner thoughts, which are bizarre.
That's great. You guys are too much, and we really appreciate you out here. We certainly do. Thank you so much for taking me up on this request that you join me today.
Thank you so much, Rose.
All right, take care now. That was Willie Robertson, author of Duck Commander Family, and also one of the stars of Duck Dynasty. And listen, if you all haven't seen that show, you have got to tune in. I don't know if there are run repeats on A&E, but I'm sure they just did their final episode for the season in Hawaii. But, you know, it really is a blessing, and it makes you wonder why, if these shows and these movies that have such strong messages about family values, about faith, why are they not doing more of that? Why do we not see more of it coming out of Hollywood, coming off of our television sets? I don't know. I don't understand it. But listen, we'll be back to talk about what you want to talk about and more after this break.
Everybody happy, happy, happy. Happy, 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 happy.
Happy, happy, happy.
Be happy, happy, happy.
She's going to be happy, happy.
Happy, happy, happy.
Happy, happy, happy.
Oh, happy, happy, happy.
Happy, happy, happy.
We're happy, happy, happy.
Everybody happy, happy, happy.